police were always around our house, really. My mum was really bad on the drugs at that time. My sister was like my mother, really. She's only a few years older than me, but she was the one always looking after me. My mum was never there. One day, we was at home and my mum said, "I'm just nipping out. Well, that'll be half an hour." And she never come back. We was in the house. I'd say a few days before one of the neighbours made a call. And then after that, I've lived with my grand and grandma ever since. I was quite a good kid in primary school and I really enjoyed it. I was rugby captain, football captain. I always remember all the kids getting up in school, bell going, and the mums and dads are waiting outside. And every day without fail, I'd be sat in that classroom waiting for my mum, watching the clock. Never turned up. I started high school and I'll never forget a teacher. She brought me and my cousin in and said, "I've been warned about you two." So that was like a step back already. I'm already this image of me and I've only just started, you know what I mean? And you get people saying, "Oh, your second name, you're such a body's relative. They've done this to me in the past." And I was getting all the aggro off what other people had done in my family or what my brother had done. And I always tried to resolve it the best I could. And then when I realised that talking wasn't going to do nothing, I kind of lived up to this name that people were giving me, this family name, this, "Oh, you're a fighter," or "Oh, you're a bad one." And then I started fighting and started making me feel better. The more I fought, the better I felt about myself. A few of the teachers, they could see in me. They could see I wasn't a bad person. They could see it in me. And I tried to hide it as much as I could. And a few took me to a side and said, like, "There's a woman here. She's starting the nurture group and we want you to try and go." I said, "Because what you've been through and your experiences in life, if you could change yourself now, it's like a... It shows other kids that they can do it, really." So they just got me to meet Michelle and have a word with her and talk to her. And honest to God, when I spoke to her, it was like best friends straight away, you know what I mean? And in the nurture, she started... The way she did it was, you never realised you was expressing yourself or telling your story or making... You always left with like a... I feel a lot better now. I feel a lot better about myself now. And I'm not as angry. It really, really helped. Like now, I can talk to anyone and I can get on with anyone, but at one time, I wouldn't speak, you know what I mean? I wouldn't talk to anyone. Always give them a stern look and then leave it at that, you know what I mean? And completely different person because of the nurture group now. I'm making my own money now, I'm making good money. I'm travelling all around the country, I've got my own van, and I'm really, really enjoying it. And it's you get to really enjoy people and enjoy the company of other people, you know what I mean? Like, if I see someone on their own, I'll just go over and start talking to them and having a joke with them. If I've never met the person before, it doesn't always go down as well as that, you know what I mean? Sometimes I think I'm a bit of a weirdo, but... My name's Shane Seddon. I'm 20 years old and I work as a composite floor decker.